Welcome to Linux and Shell Programming. Today we're going to see about the features of Linux and the types of shells. There are various features of Linux like multiprogramming, time sharing, multitasking, virtual memory, Samba, cron scheduler, licensing, web server. Among these eight features, three features are similar to general operating system, and these are special features of Linux, that is from virtual memory, Samba, cron scheduler, licensing, web server. The first feature, multiprogramming, as you already know, it allows to run several programs simultaneously by different users. Time sharing, multiple programs will share the CPU time for their execution. And multitasking, it enables the execution of multiple tasks simultaneously. Virtual memory, to optimize the use of the resources, Linux makes a portion of the hard disk available for use as virtual memory to keep frequently used programs and data, so that frequently used programs and data can be executed very fastly. Samba, it is abbreviated as Server Message Block SMB. It has been derived from that, and it is nothing but a protocol that has been used by Microsoft operating system to share the files and printers. Suite of programs that implement SMB protocol on Linux. It consists of some protocols. Using Samba, the user can share a Linux file system with Windows 95 and 98 NT. I think you can understand the Windows version of operating system can combine or share a single file with the Linux by using the Samba protocol. And it also shares a Windows 95, 98 NT with Linux. Both bidirectionally, the files can be shared when you use Samba protocol. The next one is a cron scheduler. It is nothing but a scheduler program that is used to run command scripts for programs at scheduled times. Not whenever it's needed, the what time you fix the schedule, that particular time the command scripts or programs will run. Seventh feature is the licensing. As you already know, Linux has been licensed under GNU General Public License. So the freedom what you have with that licenses, you can run the program for any purpose, you can study the program, adapt the source code you need, you can redistribute that particular copy of the program, and you can improve the program and release your improvements to the public. These freedom you have received under the GNU license. And the eighth feature is web server. Web server is nothing but it is a computer program that delivers the web pages to the internet. A process that runs an operating system and enables users to access resources that have been published in the form of web pages. By default, the Linux operating system comes with Apache web server. The advantages of Linux are reliability, backward compatibility, simple upgrade and installation process, low total cost of ownership, support for legacy devices, GUI interface, multiple distributors, excellent security features, support for high user load, support for development libraries. Next comes an important topic, Linux shells. As you already know, Linux is nothing but acts as an interface between the kernel and the user. So shell script is sequence of n number of commands that users store in a text file and execute the file instead of entering single command. So group of command, you store it in a single file, call it as shell script. It is somewhat similar to batch file that exists in MS-DOS. So the types of shells that are available in Linux are: first one, bourne shell, which is short form notation is SH. Second, C shell, CSH. Third, con shell, KSH. Fourth one, restricted shell, RSH. Fifth one, bash shell, bash. Sixth one, TCSH shell, TCSH. Seventh one, A shell. Eighth one, Z shell. The first one, bourne shell, in detail we'll see. It has been developed at AT&T laboratories by the person Stephen R. Borney. So in his name, the shell is being called as Borney shell. It is distributed with all the Unix systems. It is stored in the slash bin directory. The executable file notation is sh. It has been most widely used shell. The second one is C shell. It is developed at the University of California by the person William Joy. C shell has the syntax similar to your C programming language. The executable file notation is CSH. It is also the most widely used shell. Third one is Corn shell. It is developed at AT&T laboratories by the person David Corn. By his name, the shell is named as Corn shell. The executable file is KSH. It combines the features of Borne and Seychelles. It has a feature like 42 built-in commands and 20 command line option. Fourth one is a restricted shell. It restricts the users of OS to a limited environment because it provides only some limited access to the user, not all the rights to the user. And fifth one is the bash shell. It is being abbreviated as Borne again shell. It is being developed by Brian Fox and Chet Rame. It is the enhancement on Borne shell. It is a product of Free Software Foundation's project. The default shell is stored in the slash bin directory. It has 48 built-in commands and a dozen command line option. SH command is a symbolic link to the bash. And the sixth type of shell is TCSH shell. It is being called as Tom's C shell. It has enhancement of C shell. It is a compatible version of Berkeley Unix C shell. It is also known as TC shell. CSH command is a symbolic link to the TCSH shell. The executed by the abbreviation CSH or TCSH. It has 53 built-in commands and 18 command line option. A shell. It has been developed by Kenneth Olmquist of University of Berkeley. It emulates Borne shell. For computers with limited memory, the smallest shell is available. The executable file is ASH. This shell has 24 built-in commands and 10 different command line options. The last shell is Z shell. It combines the features of TCSH and Borne shells. Number of utilities and extensive documentation resides in a shell. And the executable file is ZSH. It is one of the largest shell for Linux because it includes 84 built-in commands and more than 50 different command line options. That's all. It emulates the SH and KS shell commands. These are the types of shells that are available in Linux with built-in commands and different command line options. So any of the above shell, any eight types, whatever it may be, it reads command from the user through the keyboard or mouse and tells the Linux operating system what the user needs. If you are giving commands from the keyboard, it is called as command line interface. Usually, that particular commands are given in front of this dollar prompt. This dollar prompt is nothing but it denotes that you are in the shell and the environment that is being set by the administrator. So, to use a particular shell type, type the shell name at the command prompt and type $CSH. It will switch the current shell to C shell because CSH is the abbreviation of C shell. To view the available shells in the system, just type cat space slash etc slash shells at the command prompt. To view the current shell you're using, type echo echo space dollar capital shell at the command prompt. For to see all the available shells in the system, just type dollar cat space etc space slash shells. It is a procedure to work in the shell script environment. Thank you.